Christmas Eve is a huge night for Santa Claus. He has to deliver presents all around the world to millions of children. And the time zones are really important for Santa Claus to help him achieve this. In this video, I'm going to dive into time zones and I'm going to show you how Santa Claus uses them on his journey on Christmas Eve. Hi there, you're very welcome to this episode of The Superhero Scientist. And in this video, I'm going to be talking about the time zones and how Santa Claus uses them on Christmas Eve. I'm Dr. Barry Fitzgerald, the Superhero Scientist, and I'm fascinated by Santa Claus and what he achieves on this huge day in his year. Because Santa Claus really does turn to science and engineering to help him achieve what he actually does. On Christmas Eve, it's a race against time as he strives to deliver presents all around the world. I've always wondered though, where exactly does he start his journey? I can tell you for one thing, it's not in Ireland. For many years, I always thought it was Ireland because I'm from Ireland. In fact, he starts his journey somewhere around here. It's somewhere in the middle of the Pacific Ocean at that point that I've marked on the map. Now it's to the left of that dashed line, and that's an imaginary line that runs from the North Pole to the South Pole that's known as the International Date Line. And I'm going to explain a little bit more about that in a few moments. Now that point that's on the map, that's actually an island. It's called Christmas Island. And Christmas Island is home to around 5,000 to 6,000 people, which of course includes children. And it's at this point that Santa Claus starts delivering presents. But what's so important about that line, and how is it related to time zones? Well, I'm going to get into some of the detail on this and explain to you how Santa can use time zones on Christmas Eve. And to do so, I'm going to jump into an explainer. Okay, so for the explainer, a little bit of a change of scenery here. I'm actually in the middle of the Pacific Ocean. Well, of course not. This is just an illustration of what the Pacific Ocean would look like. Now, over there is the International Date Line. That's going to be an important line I'm going to be talking about in relation to how Santa Claus uses the time zones on Christmas Eve. To start the explanation, well, we need a starting point. That's going to be Christmas Island. That's the point at which Santa Claus starts deliveries on Christmas Eve. And the end point, I'm going to say, is American Samoa. This is an island which is to the right of the International Date Line and roughly one of the last locations that Santa Claus will visit on Christmas Eve. Let's imagine the following situation. Santa Claus starts his deliveries on Christmas Eve, roughly around 7 o'clock in the evening at Christmas Island. Now, because of the time zones, it means that the time at American Samoa is actually 6 o'clock in the evening the day before. This might sound a little bit confusing, but this is the magic, the joy of the International Date Line. If you go from Christmas Island to American Samoa, you're actually going to gain a day backwards. It's as if you went back in time. But if you go from American Samoa to Christmas Island, you'll actually lose a day, as if you've gone to the future, but you really haven't. Now, to go through the explanation of how the times work, I'm going to put a point in between these two locations, and that's going to be Galway in Ireland. So let's take a look at the first instance. Santa Claus starts delivering presents at Christmas Island roughly around 7 o'clock in the evening on Christmas Eve. The time at that moment at American Samoa is 6 o'clock in the evening on December the 23rd. But in Galway in Ireland, the time is 5 o'clock in the morning on Christmas Eve. When Santa Claus finishes at Christmas Island, he's going to start traveling across Asia towards Europe and eventually reaches Ireland and Galway at roughly around 8 o'clock on Christmas Eve evening. Now let's look at the times at the two islands in the Pacific Ocean. Christmas Island, that's where he started deliveries. The time there is 10 o'clock in the morning on Christmas Day. But at American Samoa, the time is 9 o'clock in the morning on Christmas Eve. So children on Christmas Island have already woken up, opened their presents and are playing with them. While the children on American Samoa, well, they still have to go through the entirety of Christmas Eve before they can go to sleep and then wake up to their presents. Now, Santa Claus delivers roughly around 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, depends on the weather conditions at most locations, including Ireland. So please keep that time in mind when you're thinking about the bedtime on Christmas Eve. Now, the last one I want to look at is when Santa Claus reaches American Samoa. This is one of his final destinations on his delivery schedule. Let's take a look at the times. Now, Santa Claus reaches American Samoa to deliver presents roughly around 8 o'clock on Christmas Eve, local time in American Samoa. At that moment in time, at Christmas Island, the time is 9 o'clock in the evening on Christmas Day. That means children have played with their toys all day and are probably asleep and exhausted after all of the fun they've had. Galway, however, the time is 7 o'clock in the morning on Christmas Day. Many children may have already woken up and opened their presents, but others may be still asleep and are looking forward to the surprises left by Santa Claus. This all sounds a little bit confusing, right? These time zones that are in place, that have been there since actually the end of the 19th century, that all the different points on the planet have a different time depending on where you are. Well, that seems like, yeah, something that can take a while to get used to, especially the international dateline. But it's certainly not the case for Santa Claus. He knows exactly how they work. He uses them to his advantage. And time zones are really important for Santa Claus on Christmas Eve. And there you go. That is how Santa Claus uses the time zones to his advantage to deliver presents on Christmas Eve. I've used the example of Christmas Island to the left of the international dateline and American Samoa to the right as the extreme points of Santa's delivery schedule on Christmas Eve. And it has to be said that the time zones really do help him. Because of them, he gets roughly around 30 or 31 hours, hugely advantageous for Santa Claus on Christmas Eve. If you want to know more about some of the incredible science behind Santa Claus, in fact, the secret science of Santa Claus, well, you can do one of two things. First of all, you can get a hold of my book. It's called The Secret Science of Santa Claus, and you can get that at bwscience.com. Or you can subscribe to this channel because I will have more videos about some of the amazing science behind what Santa Claus does on Christmas Eve. I hope you've enjoyed this video in relation to time zones and just a little snapshot of some of the science that is behind Santa Claus's trip on Christmas Eve. I've been Barry Fitzgerald, the superhero scientist. Hope you'll tune in again for the next video. And in the meantime, always think super.